So let's now do the barn stop example. With the inverse fast Fourier transform. So again, we use the ECG contaminated with 50 Hertz. So that's the one we are going to use. Again, so we've got the 50 Hertz we would like to get rid. Remove 50 Hertz. And so let's draw our spectrum for that. So here we've got the number of tabs, and that's our midpoint here. So then we have at some point our zero here. So that's our barn stop design. So and that's our x of k here. So that's the index. So what we need to do is now we need to find these indices here. So we've got k1 and this index k2. And so they are, and then here we've got obviously the mirror. So that's what we know. So that's m minus k2, and that's here m minus k1. So that's our mirror of that. So what are now k1 and k2? And so that's just pretty easy if we think of that m corresponds to fs, our sampling rate. And so therefore if our m, which is here, corresponds to the sampling rate, then obviously here it's easy to find our 50 Hertz, which is somewhere in the middle here. So let's say that's our 50 Hertz here. So imagine we would like to start to end at 55 Hertz and start at 54. So then our K1 can be just calculated by, so if we have our 45 Hertz and we divide this by our sampling rate, then this gives us here normalized frequency. So this ranges from 0 to 1, and this is exactly how it would also move over here. Yeah, so therefore at Nyquist we would be exactly here at this point. So then we know that m is a number of samples, of our number of our frequency samples, I should say. So and therefore just by multiplying this with m, then we're getting our factor k1. And then the same we can do for k2, so that's 55 Hertz divided by fs multiplied by m. So that's exactly the same what we've also done when we manipulated with a Fourier transform frequency spectra, normalized frequency. And then this is basically scaled to the length of m. So simple as that. So with that we are getting our coefficients, and we just need to set them to zero. So let's do this now in Python. So what we need to do is we need to calculate our coefficients, k1 and k2. So the sampling rate is already defined. And so what we need to do now is we need to decide on the number of tabs So let's say 200. That's our number of tabs. And so now with that we can calculate our K1. So that's just 45 Hertz divided by Fs multiplied by M, and then our K2, that's 55 divided by Fs multiplied by M. And so now in order to have this for a slicing operation here, we should actually create an integer out of this here. So with that we have got our two coefficients K1 and K2 generated here. So what we need to do now is creating here this x of k here. So the x of k numpy, so we're creating loads of ones. So that's what we do with this command here. And so now we just need to set the right bits of this to zero here. And so that's just here k1 to k2 plus 1. So that's what we need to set to zero here. And then we need to also take care of the mirror. So m minus k2, and then this goes to m minus k1 plus 1. And then this also sets the mirror to zero. And so with that now we can just do our inverse Fourier transform of that. So let's call this here small x as before, numpy fft dot ifft and capital X. Okay, so let's at this point run this here. So no complaints from Python here. And so now we see here these are our coefficients, but we have here small complex numbers in here, imaginary numbers. We need to get rid of these. And so what I do is x is numpy, and then just the real value of x, and then we should have a real valued function here. Yeah, that's so. Then if we plot that, let's see how this looks like here. So that's our function here. And so we see, shouldn't have called this ECG here, So we see here that the impulse response here is wrongly ordered. So that's here the positive time, that's a negative time here, and so we need to swap these two here. And now I call this here h. So let's call h numpy zeros of m. Let's just first create an empty impulse response here, and now we need to do this this nasty swapping here. So int of m half, so that's the first half, and we would like to get that from the second half. And so then this is coming here from m half to m, and then the other way around. So I can just steal this from here and just name it h. And then this becomes this part here. clear the console here. So let's run this. So let's run. So if I now do plot of h, here we go. And so we see that the impulse response looks nice and ordered here, and we see also a window function is badly needed here on the edges, because it's just quite brutally chopped off here on the end. And so we could also add a just for our convenience here window function. Humming M. Yeah, so that looks much better on the edges here, and we see that the window function makes this here decay to the sides. And so now we are ready to filter our ECG. And so let's call this here Y2, and then signal L filter of so coefficient is H1, Y. So let's see if this runs. This runs successfully. So if we then do so a PL dot plot and zoom in. So we see here that the 50 hertz is nicely removed compared to where we started. And so we see here with the inverse Fourier transform, that's a very, very easy way of creating filter responses. And much more flexible, because we can just create any array here we would like to have, and then with that creating all different kinds of weird and fancy frequency responses.